talking about the sinfulness of sin, and that is a serious issue. In our slide program, that's the title of it, we'll just go ahead to slide number 2. We have a text, and you might want to look this up in your Bibles. It's Romans chapter 7 and verse 13. In that text, Paul says, "But sin, that it might appear sin, working death in me, by that which is good, that sin by the commandment might become exceeding sinful." God wants us to understand just how sinful, just how bad sin is. In our third slide, we have a text from Isaiah chapter 30 and verse 1. It says, "Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord, that take counsel, but not of me, and that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin." And sometimes we experience this in our lives, or we see it in other lives, where sin is added to sin, and the effect becomes multiplied. Now, our experiment we're going to do today is really actually a fairly famous experiment, but we're going to give it a little different spin than a lot of other people do. But the items needed, as you see in slide number 4, are a raincoat, some glasses or goggles, a funnel or a test tube. We're going to use some diet soda. In this case, we picked Big K brand. And you know why we chose this one?
Because it's big.
It's the cheapest.
Oh.
But because it's big too, that's nice. But we also chose diet, and it's best to be warm. And we also have something called Mentos. Have you ever seen Mentos put in Coca-Cola before?
Yes.
No? Some have, some haven't. We're going to see what happens here in a minute. But what really is going to happen is there's going to be an eruption. There's going to be almost like an explosion. In fact, we could create a rocket, but we're not going to do that today. Because we are being a little more sedate. But the procedures we see in the next slide is to put on the raincoat and glasses. We're going to place the soda on the table or on a stand outside. You do this outside. Never do this inside, Benjamin, or anyone else who's listening. And we're going to place the soda on the table, and we're going to quickly dispense some of the Mentos into the cola bottle by putting them either in a test tube or in a funnel with a paper underneath of it. And then we'll let them all slide in very quickly as we slide the paper out, and then we move away fast. And we're going to do all that outside, but we're going to do all the explaining first while we're inside. And what's going to happen is there's going to be an eruption. And this eruption is going to occur because of something called nucleation. That's a big term, but it doesn't involve radiation. It doesn't involve anything nuclear. It's called nucleation. Nucleation is a physical reaction which occurs when components in a solution start to precipitate out, forming nuclei which attract more precipitant. Slide number 7. The Mentos look smooth. If you look at a Mentos, they actually look smooth. They feel somewhat smooth, but if you magnify them, they have thousands and thousands of microscopic little bumps on them. And these bumps are places that allow the nucleation to begin quickly in many places so that the carbon dioxide is released that's in the soda. You see, a lot of people like to drink sodas because of the fizz in it. You see, that's the carbon dioxide in it. And what the Mentos is going to do, it's going to allow the carbon dioxide to be released extremely quickly in the soda. Slide number 8. We've chosen diet soda for 2 reasons. First of all, when it spills all over the person who's doing it, it won't be so sticky to clean up. Now, hopefully we're going to do this in a way it doesn't spill on anyone. But also because of actually some of the artificial sweeteners in the diet sodas, there's less surface tension. And we've talked about surface tension before, haven't we? That brought a smile, that's right. Slide number 9. So the diet soda has artificial sweeteners, and you know, we understand that these kind of chemicals probably are not good for our health. At best, they would be not recommended. And of course, these colas, they have caffeine in them, so we know that they're not healthy to drink. Do you know what the first ingredient of Mentos is?
Sugar.
Probably sugar.
It's sugar. Do you know what the next ingredient is?
Sugar.
Glucose syrup. And then the third ingredient is actually a hydrogenated oil. And so we know that they're not very healthy for us. And what we're going to illustrate, though, is a principle in slide number 11. Neither the soda, though, nor the candies are good for us. But together, they create an especially bad effect. Just like whenever we add 1 plus 1, we think we get 2, right? And that's usually true. But instead of two bad things happening, it's like when people take drugs and alcohol and they mix them together. People who are drinking, they start to take drugs, or people who are drugs start to drink. They don't get a 1 plus 1 equals 2 effect. They get more like a 1 plus 1 equals 4, 5, or 6. The one has an effect of heightening the effect of the others. And so what we're going to see as we put the two problematic components together, we're not going to see a chemical reaction. It's a type of physical reaction when we've combined the baking soda and the vinegar before in some of the other experiments. That was a chemical reaction, but this is simply called a physical reaction working with components that are already there. And this reminds me in slide 13 of what it says in Hosea chapter 8 and verse 7. In our spiritual lives, when we add sin to sin, we have troubles that are far more than simply the total of the two evils. So God told Hosea, "For they have sown the wind, and they have reaped the whirlwind." And so we think, you know, it's not so much just a little here, a little there, but it actually ends up being a bad thing. And so our last slide here says, "Remember now thy Creator in the days of thy youth." Ecclesiastes 12:1. Okay, now we're outside. And as you can see, it's snowing a little bit. I have my eye protection on. And we have the Mentos. And so what we're going to do is we're going to fold our piece of paper here just so it's a little stiffer. And open up our soda. You can hear it. Hopefully my mic over here is picking it up too. We want to open it slowly because we don't want it to foam out on us yet. We want some of that good foam to stay in there. And so now I'm going to open the package of Mentos here. And we're going to put, maybe about 5 or 6 of these into our funnel since we get it opened enough. And again, the Mentos, they look sort of smooth. Now, there's different kinds of Mentos. If you want to try to replicate this experiment, don't buy the ones that are collared with glaze on them because the glaze keeps the nucleation from occurring, or at least quickly occurring. But these here, we're going to put them now in a little funnel so that the funnel has a big opening. And we're going to set this on top like this and pull our paper over. And then when I'm going to pull out, we're going to keep our camera focused here, not on me. But I'm going to move out of the way pretty quick as... And as you can see, most of the pop got spewed out by the carbon dioxide eruption, and we didn't even get all the little Mentos that we wanted to in it. But if we wanted to do this experiment again, we can let Ashley try to replicate this. Do you want to try to do this, Ashley?
Sure.
Then you'll need to go in and get me another piece of paper because my piece of paper got soaked. And so while she's going to get the piece of paper, we're going to set up the next eruption here and get it ready for her. And you should probably put on this jacket.
This jacket works.
Well, this one looks more official. and it will keep your other jacket from getting tarnished. If just put it on over top of it. There you go. We're outfitting her here, you see. Okay. And need your eye protection. Does it look cool? All right. And so open up your Mentos now. I'm going to scoot this down just a little bit for her. Okay, let's go ahead and put some in here. A test tube works real nice if you can line them up exactly right. Okay, that's good enough. Okay, now what we're going to do, we'll set this here and I'll let you pull it out after I move way out of the way. And if they don't just immediately fall in, just jiggle this quickly and then get out of the way quickly. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Go for it. Okay, great. Well, you see what happens is the Coca-Cola or the Big K Cola, whatever we have here, still foaming, you see. The Mentos is going to the bottom, and all that pressure is building up and coming up into the narrow funnel and then shooting out. The Mentos are not healthy, we know that. This is also a little health lesson for us, too. They're not healthy for us, but we know the cola is not healthy, and drinking the cola is not so good, and drinking the Mentos is not so good. eating the Mentos is not so good. But when we put them together, we get a heightened effect. And so it's best to live healthy and not add sin to sin, not only in our physical life, but in our spiritual life as well. So thank you for being with us today in beautiful West Virginia.